people, hi. Hope everyone is safe and well during this quarantine. The lockdown has been crazy and it don't seem to end, and it's been going on and on forever. The lockdown has been difficult, and my heart goes out to everyone who's suffered during this pandemic. A lot of lives and careers have been destroyed. My heart goes out to each one of them. While it has been a very, very difficult time, it has also been an extremely learning experience. So here are my five things that I've learned during this lockdown. For a guy whose biggest achievement has been to make an omelette in the kitchen, I realized that cooking is actually fun. I was stranded in Bombay for 3 months. I have cooked so much during these 3 months, which I never thought I would ever do. Of course, it started off like a chemistry experiment where, you know, you approach it with all these ingredients and you start putting things together, and all the smoke and the flavors and the smell and everything. A lot of burnt vessels in the beginning, but I started really enjoying it. And I mean, I didn't have much choice and didn't want to eat ramen every day or bread every day. So I started cooking, and I kind of realized that cooking can be extremely therapeutic. Trying out different recipes from YouTube, where I've been cooking, I've been covering certain culinary depths. It's actually a lot of fun and therapeutic, and you know, so does including dishwashing, which I never really did during my time. It was quite therapeutic in nature. So yeah, that's number one. Number two, value. This 3 months of being alone, shut in the house, for a guy like me, to stay alone is not a big deal, because I think creative people might resonate with me. I get energy when I'm alone. I really enjoy my own company, so I tend to make these little projects. I get time to think and process information and make these side projects. I sit and paint, I sit and read. That is not so much the problem, but I believe that there's this constant media talking about the people falling sick and people dying and the family being so far away. Value for people was something that immediately, you know, came into me in the first few days itself. I was worried about my family. I was worried about their health and safety. It was not just about my family. I also, you know, realized that the word value was also for anybody that I must have come across in my life. And I wondered if they're all right during this time, you know, because I was talking to a friend of mine, and I said it takes a pandemic to reach out to each other, you know, because we are such good friends, and it's such a shame that it takes a pandemic for us to actually take a mobile phone and to reach out to each other and to check. And value for people. And apart from that, you know, I also realized we can also immediately brings back the mortality of our lives. You know, it's so brittle that something small could happen and we could just vanish from Earth. And I think this entire pandemic has taught me to value not just my family and friends that I have, but also to value everything that I'm privy to, and also to value the things that I actually possess. For example, the kind of comforts that I have, the kind of the nature that we are surrounded by, the environment that we live in, the environment, the water that we consume. Realizing that I've not been giving the due respect and attention to things that I'm privy to, and COVID is also a result of us being less attentive towards the nature and environment that we have. So value is something that I definitely learned during this pandemic. Number three, learning. The last 3 months, I've been spending a lot of time on the internet, and I realized that there's so much of content for learning on the internet. Of course, it's been there before, and there's so much of courses. There are so many courses. There is courses on every subject that you can think about, so easily accessible to you through the internet. I have been learning relentlessly during this entire time, and I also realized that what learning does for you is that it just gives you, it also opens up a whole different aspect of of things that you already know just opens up a new perspective for it. Starting from knitting to whether starting to how to walk a dog, we can find content of that on the internet. And until this pandemic, maybe I am starting to think that maybe I wasn't using that so much. Of course, I was learning. I'm a relentless learner and I read a lot on the internet. But the kind of courses and structured courses that I see on the internet, probably I've not used it so much. And I'm starting to utilize that a lot more. I've been learning relentlessly for the entire 3 months. And I think it also, what learning is also doing is pushing me to take action, which is the next segment that I'm going to be talking about.
Number four, take action. One of the other very important thing that I learned during this pandemic is to take action. I know it's complete opposite of what you could do during a lockdown, but also this, the amount of time that it has given us to think and ponder over and to process the kind of information that you have in your head, it also allows you to take action in your life. And that is something that I've learned a lot. So I've been putting forth a lot of things, or very important things that is really close to my heart for a very long time. For people who already know that I have been part of the creative industry and in various capacities for more than 15, 20 years. I've been a filmmaker, I've been a creative director, I've been a writer, I've worked in television, I've worked in cinema for over 10 to 15 years now. And what people don't know is also that, and the second most important thing that's close to my heart and is what I'm very passionate about is human mind and psychology, right? I have been training practicing and learning psychology for the past 9 years, 9-10 years almost. And I've done hypnotherapy, I've done neuro-linguistic programming, I have done a master's in my psychology, in counseling psychology and cognitive behavior therapy. By being, being a psychologist and also functioning in creative business, I have, what has opened me to is the amount of challenges that a creative person goes through on a day-to-day basis, right? And I think I should bring out what happened with Sushant Singh Rajput, which has been something which has deeply affected a lot of these people. And creative people by itself are extremely sensitive people. We have a very different kind of construct in terms of cognitively that we have, and we have very rich, sensorially rich experiences, which also helps us to create beautiful things in our life. At the same time, it also affects us much more intensely than an ordinary person. Being a creative person myself and also having worked with different creative people throughout this last 10, 15 years, I've seen all type of challenges that a creative person goes through, the kind of mental processes that they have to overcome, what pushes for greater performance, what pushes them down, what motivates them and what triggers them. These are something that I've observed and learned, and I've also built these psychological processes that I've observed and created these sets of processes with my own experiences and what I've learned from psychology. So this is what pandemic, what it has done is it has pushed me, because I've just kept it. I kept thinking that the time is not right for me to start something. Maybe I will do it when I have a little bit more time. I thought that maybe I will, once I've finished a couple of things and then I'll do it. But why wait? I think, one of the things about what this pandemic has also taught is, like I discussed earlier, is the mortality of our lives. And the reason why I even want to be in psychology is that it's to know that I can make a positive impact on somebody else. And this is also my vision statement. I try to create a positive impact, whether it is my advertising film, whether it is for a brand, or whether it is whether it's a feature film. I'd like to tell a story which impacts positively on somebody else. And here is an opportunity where I can reach out to one-to-one, where the others are a little more wider and I don't see the person. With psychology, I can connect to a person one-to-one and I can try and make a very positive impact on that person. And this is the first reason that attracted me to psychology, first of all, and also because I've gone through these challenges myself. So this is what I'm doing right now. I've started up a practice on psychology. I'm starting up creativity performance coaching for creative individuals. I'm also a life coach. I help people to overcome situations and life challenges that's stopping them from getting great. I take them from where they are to where they could be. Completely depends on where they want to be in the first place. And I also do filmmaking mentorship. to help other filmmakers to come up, whether they want to get into advertising or whether they want to get into feature length films or to learn about how to make films. So this is something that I would be working on starting now. Why coaching, and why do I want to coach other people, and what is coaching? You know, because a lot of people don't understand when I say I'm a performance coach or I'm a creativity coach, or when I say that I'm a life coach, people don't, especially when I say creativity coach, a lot of people don't understand what I do. So let me just tell you that with an illustration of a story. When human beings were created, right? I mean, the way we were created, as per the Hindu mythology, we were created by Brahma, the four-headed god, you know, as per the Hindu mythology. And when he created human beings, apparently we were all created with the power of God, right? So he created them, let them be, and some time passed, and one day he kind of noticed that the entire gods from Devlok, you know, the Indras and the Vayu, you know, I'll say all the gods rather, from these places have all gathered to come and meet with Brahma. And well, they have a big issue. The issue was that they were like, dude, Brahma, how could you just give all these powers to men, right? They're misusing. Brahma observed men, and he kind of realized that, you know, men being men, when I say men, by the way, I mean men and women, have been absolutely abusing the powers that has been given to them. You know, they've been lazy, they've not been attending to things, you know, they've been using these powers and utilizing it for the wrong reasons. So Brahma and everybody said, you know, you have to take these powers off, because if you don't do that, there's a high possibility that these men could also come to Devlok and wage a war against us. Brahma thought for a moment, he observed men, and he said, yes, you're absolutely right. Let me take that off, right? So he took off that entire power. But there was just one problem, right? What does he do with this power? So some smart god said that, why don't you just put it on top of Mount Everest? And Brahma said, no, because human beings evolved from apes anyway, right? So you cannot, because they'll climb and find it. Somebody suggested, why don't you bury it under the ocean? They said, no, he could swim and find it. And so that's not a solution either. Somebody suggested under the earth. No, they can dig, they'll find it. Brahma thought for a couple of days, and he came up with a very smart idea. So this is what Brahma did. Brahma took all those powers of God, right? That immense power of creation, and put it inside men itself. However, kept them ignorant of it. They will look anywhere else and everywhere else except but themselves, right? They will not look inside them to find that power. We all have it. We all have that power to do exceptional things and great things. We can achieve any dream that we want to achieve. We can set that dream, go behind it, and achieve it. Most times, the reason that we do not move ahead in our life is because of some psychological blockades that we have for ourselves. There will be some sort of a mental block that we have. A lot of people also struggle from creative blocks. They don't know how to, they reach a certain point, they don't know how to finish a project, or they don't know how to start a project. And then there's creative blocks, and there is writing blocks, and there is performance blocks, and then there's constant distraction that happens. And these are the areas that I can primarily help people with.
So that's what a creativity coach does, and that is what I'm very excited to do for you. So I, starting effectively, I am a creativity performance coach and a life coach, and a mentor for filmmakers. I invite you all to reach out to me if you feel that we could, you know, I could help you in some way. And that leads on to number 5. Loving yourself. Another thing that I realized during this pandemic is the importance of self-love. It is not because, probably because this entire pandemic is, you know, of course you fall sick and you start thinking about death and mortality and everything. It also immediately brings about, you know, the self-protection thing, probably because of that. But beyond that as well, I also realized that, you know, when you protect yourself and when you have love for yourself, you tend to do a lot more things in your life. To tell you about my own experience, I think I used to question every decision of mine when I started off as a creator, when I started off as a filmmaker. And that lack of love and lack of
faith in my own ability used to keep me very limited. And that is also one more reason why I took such a long time to say, okay, now I'm ready to go out and do a movie. While I had written scripts and movie scripts for a very long time. And to choose something which is, you know, I always kind of, it kind of kept me limited. But the moment I kind of started believing in my own ideas and believing in myself, and I started loving myself, I started coming out with better things. My creativity improved. The kind of films that I did started looking much better. I was able to apply what I was thinking, because if I was coy before, I was not. I was able to tell people this is how I see it, and very boldly, and also convince people. I kind of realized that, you know, if you have a very powerful or a strong point of view, and if that makes sense and if it's absolutely brilliant, there is nothing that can stop you. And if you have talent, it will, people will see it one way or the other. It is, success is bound to come to you. And you know, finding that love for myself definitely changed a lot of things in my life. And I think that resulted in the kind of films that I did, that resulted in the movie that I did. It has resulted in the book that I'm writing right now, which is due to release very soon. I'm very excited to share that with you. And it is also resulting in the career that I've chosen to help others, right? I mean, that by loving myself, I'm able to love others as well. And I'm able to share a little bit of, and there is nothing like, you know, it never gets depleted. The more and more you share with people, and when you try to bring up other people, you also grow as well. Being a creativity coach and working with all these artists already, I kind of, you know, I see that I'm growing as a human being every day. And so I'm loving my profession profoundly at this point in time. And I have a couple of clients already who have already started seeing some phenomenal success, whether it is financial or whether the kind of growth, whether in terms of their, you know, where they could be in terms of kind of things that they can achieve. And very importantly, they are happy. So I'm very happy that I've chosen that. So yes, self-love is important. So guys, these are the five things that I've learned during this pandemic. Love yourself, okay, and stay safe, stay well. This too shall pass. There is any time when there has been a situation, when there has been a slump, or when there has been a dip, people have only come out much stronger. There are two types of people. When you fall, you can either, you know, start sinking, or you are a person who can bounce back much higher, like as if you are actually jumping on a trampoline. You can come much higher than what you were before. Use this time to recreate yourself. Use this time to be much stronger than what you were before. Happy to reach out and connect with you all. I will see you again with another video. Take care. Bye-bye.